you've got a friend.
Was it one of those songs that writes itself really fast?
Right.
Yeah. And, you know, as soon as I heard it, I said, man, that's just it. That's a great, great song. Peter sort of asking you, you know, we want to put this on the album. What do you think? And you were generous enough to say, sure, this fantastic tune. She's recording herself, and she allows me to have the first shot at it.
I think all you gotta do is call.
You know, hearing your rendition of it for the first time, it was like, oh my God, it's perfect. Really.
It was funny. It was one of those things that was, we had been in the studio. I think we had this extra time left over. We all knew the song because we'd heard you play it, because we were at the Troubadour doing that gig together, and you were playing it every night. You know, and it was so loose.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, Lee's playing all over the place on that. I mean, it's the most notey bass part in the history of popular music. It's like he's playing like arpeggios, you know, on the bass. And you know, Russ just laid down a conga part to it, and Cooch was playing. Everything was very, very loose. It was. For one thing, I didn't assume that we were going to be able to release it because I hadn't asked you permission. But that's the backstory to the backstory anyway.
Right. And yeah. Then, you know, also when we play it together, when we played in the Troubadour reunion tour,
mm-hmm.
It's basically your arrangement pretty much, which is not that different from mine,
no,
but it
that.
Is because my piano, I had to change some of the chords to meet your arrangement, but it was perfect. Perfect. I wanted to do that. But the way your guitar blends with my piano part is just, it's like that first time we played together. It's that.
That's got that thing.
We did that, buddy.
That thing.
We did that.